All right, so this is day two of the seminar. We're here with the elder David. Stop him. You can stop him, but just let him go on right here. So David, what is your opinion from yesterday's seminar, day one? How did you see that event? How do you think that event took place and ended up based on your perspective?
Well, if you're a Christian, like I used to be, if you didn't go to church that Sunday, they always tell you, oh man, you should have been here last week. It was the best service. You always seem to miss the best services. So those of you who missed it yesterday, you missed a good seminar. So don't miss the next one.
Did you learn anything?
Yes, I did.
What did you learn?
Well, I learned about the social security numbers and them cards, or the dollar bill you had up there. Mm-hmm. And I learned that I could actually stand up in front of a room and not faint. So that was cool.
Okay. All right, let's pass the mic, man.
Shalom.
All right, Cody, so what did you think of yesterday's seminar, man? This is day two. This is your second one, actually, here.
Yeah, second one in person, and second to none, these seminars. I've been to a lot of different venues, a lot of different seminars dealing in contracting commercially, and the information here is top-notch and second to none that you can find out there, and very informative, more than what was disclosed on the, you know, the advertisement as far as what you're going to receive when you're here.
Right.
So anyways, and then about learning yesterday, I mean, we covered so many different things, but understanding more about how the courts are operating in trust.
Right.
The little you did touch on is some big key understanding that people don't understand, that trust law is literally controlling their life through contracts.
Right.
So, anyways, that's just happy to be here, happy everybody's here, you're in the right spot if you're here.
And Jim, Jim, where's your husband?
Is he in the room instead of the car? He was getting something out of the car last time I saw him. David said hi.
Hey, you can tell your husband to come on down.
Thank you.
Play like Price is Right and come on down. Yeah. Go ahead. Hold on. Put $10 on the table. We're going to need 10 bucks. Let's go to Jaidir. We're going to need $10 on this guy, man.
Shalom, shalom.
No, so what did you think about yesterday's seminar? This is your first time, right? Yeah, this is your first seminar.
My first seminar?
Yeah.
Many webinars. Yeah, this is my first seminar. It's been a blessing so far. I got a lot of clarity on 1099A and 1099 OID. I got some clarity on the Social Security bond numbers. I did know that, but then I needed just a refresh. So
right.
It's good to go over these things again multiple times. So don't be discouraged if you didn't get it the first time, because you will see it again and again and again before you actually get it.
Right.
That's why you got to get the books. I got two new books to finish my collection, so I'm excited to get on that when I get back home. Praise be that we're all here. Hope everyone had a good night's rest, because we're about to get at it.
Is the gentleman next to you, is he your stylist? Mr. Body, is that your stylist?
I'm actually his stylist.
Okay. Oh, okay.
I'll pass it over to him.
I noticed the men that's dressed fresh is in the room is up front, adjacent to each other.
Shoulder to shoulder.
Nah, we don't want to use that term anymore.
You
better watch your wallet. You better watch your wallet. We don't want to use that, man. So, go ahead, Anthony.
Shalom. I appreciated this.
Stand up.
Jeremiah. Jeremiah trying to use his size, man. A bully. A young bully, man.
Learning about how to move in commerce. This is second seminar, but it was definitely good to see a refresher, because the first time you're not going to be able to retain everything. And like the brother here said before, I think it's important to get the books, just like you would get a textbook in college to refer. It's more important that you could go back, reread, and fully understand. So I just want to say I appreciate it. Oh, and also I also appreciate you bringing this back to scripture as well to show how this is more of a spiritual journey, more so than a fleshly journey.
Cool. Appreciate it, brother.
Yo, how y'all doing? How y'all doing?
We doing good, brother. What about you?
Good.
Every day, always a perfect day.
Oh, yeah, new day.
What was your name again, King?
Caleb.
Caleb.
Yeah.
All right.
Just came back. A lot of information yesterday, but I ain't even gonna lie. Like, I got it all, but we gonna try. We gonna keep trying. I bought a book yesterday, so came back. We gonna go at it again. Try to gain, try to retain some of this information.
I'm right
here.
Terrence.
Shalom, shalom, everybody.
Shalom.
This is my second seminar, panelist webinars. Gotta keep it going. You're not gonna retain it all. Okay, who you are, you're not gonna retain it all the first go around, but just stick with it. I brought one of my sons. I was supposed to bring my brother. I'll bring the other two next time, so. Gonna keep it going. Everybody,
come. It was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine. Biggie, they is your Biggie back reincarnated. I love it when they call me Big Papa. Yeah, come on, man. Y'all can't tell me he don't resemble Biggie, man.
It was a definite experience yesterday.
He got the same
a webinar too. The seminar definitely a different experience. I'm gonna try to write a little bit faster today than I did yesterday, so I can try to get more information. But I like this school, there's something to learn. Get to it.
Hey, wait, brother. Damn, where's Carefoot?
Shalom, family.
Shalom.
Good morning. My name again is David, family of Tamabosa. Traveled from Washington State. Yesterday, I learned how to acquire back my energy. Through the 1099A and 1099 OID. More importantly, I got to see the Tazadok, Kahan Tazadok, and the rest of the family. So I'm very thankful and grateful for that.
I got a question for you, David. What did you think about Purim, those scriptures you was going over?
Oh, yeah, I missed the Purim. I apologize for that very much.
Yeah, but David, your pizza damn sure did taste good.
Appreciate you guys, though.
All right, man. All right, appreciate it, man. I give it to Michael. Give it to Michael, man. Richard, let Mike get it right now. So, what did you think about it yesterday, Mike? Oh, Mike's hiding, man.
Oh, stand up on the chair real quick. You're too little. There you go. You're good. That's good. That's good.
So what did you think about yesterday, Mike?
Yeah, talking to the mic. Put the mic by your chin.
He's thinking right now. He's processing. Remember yesterday, 10 minutes, he came back with a thing. Well, I'm not Michael. I'm a Xavier. When I walked in today, they kept saying, I'm Michael. I'm a Xavier. I'm Michael. I'm a Xavier. So what'd you think yesterday, Mike? No comment.
What'd you think about Purim?
No comment, huh?
Did you like the pizza?
Yes.
What about those Oreos? There we go. What do you think about those Oreos, Mike?
It was fine.
All right. Let's see what Xavier has to say.
Stand up.
What about you, Xavier? What do you think about the Purim?
Good.
All right. What you think about the Oreos? Vanilla and chocolate.
You said
brilliant.
You said brilliant?
Brilliant.
Oh, wow. Where you get that from?
All right. Let's give it back to Richard, man. Hand it back to Uncle Richard behind you there.
I guess it was about the seminar or the rim.
Yeah, I guess both, man. I don't know.
So we get feedback.
As far as the seminar, I'm very appreciative of the opportunity to stay abreast on the information. Because if you don't use it, you lose it type situation.
So
that's my appreciation on that end. And as far as morale, the appreciation of the situation.
Can't hear you.
That's the situation where
there we go.
You know, vying for the Jews in front of the king to be able to hold up for what they were standing for. And appreciate
it. Who's next?
Miss Chan, go ahead, Miss Chan. Miss Chan, can some of y'all?
Shalom. What I learned yesterday was just do it. Just do the process.
Right.
You know? And do it and have fun with it. Be creative with it. Like, what I learned from yesterday was there was a lot of cast spelling. A lot of, they were doing a lot of but they went off the Lord was just do the paper and just do it.
All right.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Shalom, brothers and sisters.
Shalom.
I'm Derek from yesterday, first seminar. But I learned he who does not deny it admits it.
Right.
Cool. And an unrebutted affidavit stands as truth.
Right.
A lot of most stuff, you know, that I ain't gonna take up the time, but I'm getting it in, you know. So that's, you know, I'm ready for today and get some more, you know. So that's all I gotta say.
Sean. I appreciate it, King. Appreciate it.
Eric. Shalom, everybody.
Shalom.
My name is Eric White. I've been to a couple of seminars. I enjoy each and every one of them. Yesterday in particular, what I learned was interesting to find out that you can, I can, from a credit report through the tax forms, I can discharge stuff from a credit report, and a whole lot of other kind of stuff.
Cool.
I enjoyed it.
So, all right.
Look forward to this. Thank you.
Nice.
Okay, shalom everyone. Peace. Shalom.
Shalom, King. Shalom.
All right. Yesterday was very enlightening. I learned a lot about dealing more on the public and private side when it comes to you know, different businesses and stuff like that. I got aware about using the 1099 form because I was only aware of it using it one way, and I got introduced in a whole other way to use it so far as discharging debt. And this is my second seminar, so each one is very enlightening in so far as what you can learn and how you can take control of your straw man. So yeah, definitely informative. Enjoy it. Looking forward to learning some more.
Appreciate it.
Shalom.
Yeah. Can you tell us in a rhyme, man, in a rap, man, what you won yesterday? MC Jehote, man. It's really good, man. We're doing studio time.
We ain't gonna do that. We ain't gonna do that. But I learned a lot yesterday. This is my second seminar I have attended. I learned a lot both times. But the most important thing that I have to say I learned was do not reserve your rights on an affidavit. That was real crucial thing for me, because I just did it, you know. I bought the books, watched the videos, and I just did it. And I noticed that there were certain things I was doing that wasn't really right, so I had to correct that. And also, purchased this book yesterday. I don't know if you can see that.
Absolutely.
But, cracked it open this AM. I'm simultaneously reading three books at a time. One being The Corporation, the other being Edom and Gazaria, first Hebrew Israelites and this one. So I said, shalom.
Shalom. This is my first seminar, but I've been to countless webinars, and I can say from webinar to seminar, this is way better. Just in terms of the way I learn, is being up close and personal with the information in front of you. You get the visual, you get the audio with the Kahana speaking, and stopping and being able to explain things that you're actually reading on the screen. It's one thing to read from the books, but it's another to be in front in person with the man who wrote the book. So that was good. We also went over public versus private, and really to understand that we're in the private, in this meeting, to understand how to operate within the public. Just so many other things, along with being able to fellowship with Akim, with Purim, it's just a blessing. And you know, I'm Barak. So
blessed.
I thank everybody for being here. And get it in on
Tawab.
Oh, he already went? And stand up, Wally. You next. Stand up. Shoulder to shoulder.
Little funny stuff, man. Go and check my snacks in the back, man. Go and check my drinks. Wally is in the building. And is it, when his head had his turn 45 degrees like that, he's on the plow again. To watch your bones.
Fucking down, fam. Glad to be here, each and every member here. I don't have a name, I have a godly attribute. Who is the paramount security holder of the entity known as W.D. Merriman.
Oh, here we go.
And I am really, I got chills just being here with you people, because everyone that I talk to, especially the Kahan, has given me something to walk out of this place with. And I can appreciate that. In that, you giving me what you giving me, I can say you all, brothers and sisters, and say, I got family. Because my blood family, I don't have none. I don't have no mother, father, uncles, aunts, cousins. All of them are gone. So that's what you've become to me by how you spoke with me.
That man, he could pitch his way out of here. Right.
I'm trying to tell you, man.
That boy could pitch to the devil. That's a hell of a pitch right there. You almost had me for you.
Man.
Han says he hears fire coming out of my voice. But I want to let the world know that's looking at this video, he did. He put fire.
That now
fire
is so like Chris out.
He put
talk to my teacher. I wish you well. The wind is 36 feet deep.
Don't forget to say that part of my week.
Well, in jest, you may say, comment on my character, but I'm standing on my square. And once again, I say, it's because of you. I am where I am. That's in pursuit of righteousness. I just want to be right. Ever how wrong the de facto say I am, I still hold on to the concept, I just want to be right. Thank you, God.
Thank you, bro. It's good. Hey, Wally, before you hang that, can you check him for wires? He might be wearing a wire.
right.
Look how warm it is. He got this big ass shirt.
Kind of stern.
So he got wires on.
And the mic gonna start staticking again.
Man, he's an agent. If the mic starts staticking, that wire is somewhere.
Shalom, everybody.
Shalom.
My name is Scott Sam Greenley.
I thought you said Scott yesterday.
Scoop. And Stan.
I got you.
He's telling us who he is.
Yeah.
You guys don't know he's talking about the spook that slipped behind the door? That was that so-called black man that infiltrated the FBI and posed at, like, he wanted to be an FBI agent, but he went in and got the information. He got trained by the FBI.
Wow.
Then he went back into the ghetto and he created a lot of...
Yes, he did.
Yeah, and you know, they was causing havoc, like, all over the cities or whatever. But they thought he was a legitimate guy. He was clean cut, all of that. So, you know, they trusted him. Mm-hmm. He got his way inside, and he trained a lot of militants to fight against the FBI. Even when I got a Nicholas Carefoot, he said, no, we can use him. We need him to be able to infiltrate. No, don't talk, man. That's a good movie. You should watch it. It's called The Spook That Stood Behind the Door.
Yeah, I do encourage you. I watched it last night again. In fact, I watched the actual person who did Sam Greenman. He had to go through to make that movie.
But
it came out and then it went away.
But I got a copy of it, man.
Yeah, we watched it on YouTube. But again, I appreciate everyone being here, learning a lot. I appreciate the friendship and relationships that are developing here. And this is a journey.
This is a journey, man.
It's a journey. And I hope I can internalize this knowledge and information and pass on. Shalom.
Appreciate you.
Deep.
Shalom, shalom, everyone.
Shalom.
Family. What I learned yesterday was a lot about the 1099 OID process. It was very complicated for me to understand. So just reading about it in the books and coming to the seminar and seeing it live up on the screen and being explained and questions asked just gives me clarity, a lot of clarity. And I enjoyed the Purim last night. It was my first Purim. Learned a lot about that. Just learning about the scriptures is new to me. And, still learning. Loving it. Glad to be here.
Appreciate you.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom. Shalom.
Shalom. Shalom.
This is my first event, first seminar. I'm gonna make sure to have it. Just for my journey, I learned a lot yesterday, but one thing that just stuck with me as far as the Social Security card, how one side is private, one side is public, on that intrusion of life. I'm very grateful. And I didn't intend to. I just plan on learning as much as I can from you guys. I'm just grateful to be here, just for this moment for me.
No doubt, appreciate you, too.
Shalom, family. Shalom. This is my second seminar. Last one was my first one. And this is constant knowledge.
Say your name.
I'm sorry. I apologize. My name is
Manny. Joe Castro.
My name is Manny.
God,
I'm from the country of Florida.
Che Guevara.
And yesterday, it was very informative, but to me, I'm more on a spiritual journey more than anything, because all this other stuff is a bonus to me. Because I feel like if you ain't in the right spiritual mind, you ain't never gonna get any of this.
Cool. Yep.
And Purim yesterday really opened my eyes, my first Purim. And just that fellowship, man, I left craving more. And
because of that, I wanna read a little Bible verse, 1 Peter,
2nd chapter. It says, wherefore laying aside all malice and all guile, and hypocrisies and envies and all evil speakings, as newborn babes desire the secure milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby. And if so be ye have tasted that the Lord is gracious. And I feel like he's been very gracious and blessed me very much with this journey.
Come on.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
My name is Jesus. I learned a lot in the seminar, but most importantly, what impacted me was the Purim. It was my first time attending to that, and it was life-changing, the scriptures, and never experienced a study like that on the scriptures. And it was just something that I felt like the Most High put me here for that, more than anything. I got everything else going on, but the Most High has got me here, and it's got me here for a reason. And I'm blessed to be around everybody who's here too, seeking. He's got you here.
Cool.
home.
Shalom, y'all.
Shalom.
Sequoia.
Shout out to the elder to her.
Nah. I'm pretty much trying to stand on my own now. You know. So basically, I enjoyed the room yesterday. One thing that stood out in the webinar was the quote, "He who is asking is as king." Mm-hmm. And then I thought about it last night, like, man, a lot of these conversations we have with these public officials, it's like we're entering contracts verbally, you know what I'm saying? By, instead of asking questions, we go argue, you know what I'm saying?
Not necessarily verbally, though. Verbally. Someone defined the word verbally. It's viva voce. Verbally doesn't always mean what you think. So we got to be real clear on what, someone look define the word verbally.
Calling the black wall.
Is verbally always audible?
No.
We got to look up all of these words.
Gotcha.
Yeah, it was a good opportunity for me to try to elaborate.
I got you.
Okay.
Strictly of or pertaining to words, expressed in words.
Okay, stop. So verbally doesn't mean it has to be vocally or people will say by voice. It could just be words, right? Doesn't necessarily have to be enunciated. Go ahead.
Whether spoken or written.
So verbally could also mean written, see? Most people think they understand language, but they don't. Like I said, it's aphasia. We need a lobotomy. Everything that we learn, we have to relearn again.
Okay.
So the correct enunciation should have been viva voce, by voice. Look that up, viva voce. That's vocally, by voice. It's Latin. Remember, most of this war stuff comes from Latin. It goes back to Rome, which goes back to what? The papacy, the Pope.
The Vatican.
Viva Fosse, with the live. Viva Fosse, Latin, with the living voice.
See that? So that's with the voice. So we've been taught in common parlance. If we say something is verbal, we think we're speaking it. It could mean you're writing it down.
Yeah,
all these little things are very important in law, man.
How does it spell?
V-I-V-A.
It's a Latin word. Tell me how to spell it, Jeremiah.
V-I-V-A-B-O-C-E.
And you know what's ironic? People hear me say this stuff all the time on YouTube, but they never pay attention to it. They decide, he's just saying verbally. No, I'm not.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I told people every word that I say is didactic. It's meant to teach something. But it goes over most people's head.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Were you done?
Yeah,
he's done.
Oh, okay.
Shalom, family.
Shalom.
Bon Yahawada, Bon Yashallah. Authorized representative of LeVar Curtis Johnson. Yesterday, I learned a lot from watching The Twilight Zone. And one thing that stuck out yesterday was in the Purim, he was speaking as far as the name. He said something to a gentleman and then replied to him as Thomas. And he was like, who is Thomas? So it's like, with the Most High, you gotta get that name right. Because if you don't have it, it's like walking into a grocery store saying mom. So.
And you and Piggly Wiggly. You ain't gonna get mama's cookies, you ain't gonna get pork.
No. I just encourage everyone to make it to these seminars.
They laughing, but they have a Piggly Wiggly's out here, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, they have it in North Carolina. I seen it with a 95.
Yep.
I encourage everyone to make it to these seminars because you're gonna receive 50 times over. Whatever you pay, or it's just the information is here. If you don't make it, you need to try your best to do what you gotta do to get here. Shalom.
Shalom. JB, the young bully.
Yep.
Stand up.
So good. So good.
Jeremiah Banks, the young bully with the patience of Gary Coleman.
So long, my name is Jeremiah Banks. I've been studying with the Kahan for almost a year now. You know, I learned a lot in the last seminar, this seminar, you know, just being around the Kahan, you know, you're gonna learn a lot of information and just, you know, feed off his energy. Just everything, just commercial presentments, how to respond, you know, contract is law, law is contract. He's been beating that over our heads for years, you know. It's just an offer, you feel me? No matter how they word it, how they try to say it, or in a threatening way, it's just an offer. And it's not what they say, it's what they do. And it's all about how you respond. Are you gonna, you know, acquiesce? You know, acquiesce is this agreement. If you don't say anything, do anything, or you're in agreements or whatever commercial presentment that they sent you. But, you know, you should be conditionally accepting the offers, you know, for information purposes only. But yeah, I just been studying, you know, so many different things, discharge of debt, EFT, A4B, 1099, turning, you know, they send you a bill, you can turn it into a money order, endorse it, getting rid of warrants, accepting it for value, return for value, just so much different stuff you can learn, and it's very just, you know, life-changing information, and I'm just happy I came across the Kahan. I was looking at how I first got into it. I was looking at, like, some of the right to travel stuff, and I was seeing people, like, basically present passports and, like, you know, get left alone, and I kind of just came across one of the Kahan's videos and attending webinars, finally seminars, and just all type of stuff, going into court, you know, presenting affidavits, you know, using my assumed name. I haven't done my SBC packet yet, but I do have an assumed name, which I got from a seminar last May. And, you know, it creates the distinction between the legal entity and the secure party, the aggrieved man. And, you know, it's just a lot. So I'm just happy to be here, still learning, you know, just trying to soak up as much information as I can and, you know, stay out of trouble. Yeah, shalom.
What you think about Purim?
The Purim, very informative. That's another thing that I want to get into. Like, not just the commercial side, but the spiritual aspect as well. You know, for to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life. Trying to, you know, balance both that as well. I like how you tie everything into the scriptures as well. He tell you, you know, this is all spiritual.
Come on.
You know, that's why a lot of people, they come around for the commerce and then kind of just drop off of, you know, this doesn't work, you know, they wasn't in the right mindset. He always say, you know, you gotta get your mind right first. It's about how you think, you know, what are you in this for? What are you trying to, you know, get up out of this? But definitely, I've been trying to study the scriptures to be a part of true disciples of Christ and just both sides. And yeah, that was a good experience. And yeah.
Come.
Shalom.
Nicholas, careful.
Stand up. Good, you're good.
I am the author's representative, hired by Carefoot Trust for NPC and Associates. I was referred to this man, the author's representative for Conan Toss and Doc, in 2016 because I was a reprobate. And since then, I have began believing in the Most High. And also from this seminar, especially yesterday, I really enjoyed Purim. I've never been invited to any of the High Holy Days before, so I made sure to make it Hades or High Waters, so I made it somehow, and I'm here. And, you know, it was, I think Purim was really, 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 really good, and I learned a lot, actually, and more so the seminar, as always, very, very informative, and, you know, there's a lot to take away, and so, you know, some of that information even yesterday I needed for something I was dealing with. So, you know, it's always good to keep studying this contract law stuff and stay in the ecclesiastical law, because at the end of the day, that's really all that's going to save you is yourself. So, shalom.
Shalom. All right, we got everybody on this side.
You got your sword on? Yeah, so let's go over something real quick. You know, we want to talk about people realize in the scriptures that there was a fake Jesus that most people, I don't say Jesus, Yahushua, that most people today worship, and they think they're worshiping the Messiah. So, no, not him. there was a man that literally carried the attribute, and he was from the tribe of Judah. He went by the name of Simon. Let's get Acts, the 13th chapter. A lot of people read the Bible, they don't even see this. They don't realize it. And then, you can pull it up in your Sephora. Is that here?
Acts 13. So,
no, nah, you ain't got
it. No, he got it. Yeah, he got it.
Verse
1? Yeah, so this man, he was from the tribe of Judah. He was a sorcerer. So that means he appeared to have the ability to work miracles, just like a Mashiach, right? So he was healing people, and he was doing miraculous things. So they looked to him as a Christ. And he carried the attribute, as you're going to see, his son, Yahusha, right? He was the son of Yahusha. And a lot of Christians, I'm going to say every Christian read the Bible, but they never catch this. They never see it. So still reading that verse 1 up?
It's the book of Acts.
Chapter 2. Well, first, someone, give me, get 2 Corinthians 11 and 4. Let's start with that. So we can see that it was prophesied, it was supposed to be a fake Messiah.
I got you.
They start worshiping a fake Messiah. I got it.
The book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 11, verse 4. For if he that cometh preacheth another Mashiach, whom we have not preached.
Okay, stop. So the prophecy is saying that someone may come preaching of another Savior that the true biblical Israelites never heard of. So it was prophesied that this was happening, right? And that's who most people worship today. They call him Jesus, J.C., Christ, and so on and so forth.
Okay. Or if ye receive another spirit.
So this guy, he had a ruach, a different spirit, right? But it wasn't holy. It was not the Ruach HaKadosh. So everyone has a spirit. There's all kind of spirits, right? Mm-hmm. But it's the Ruach HaKadosh, which means unclean spirit, right? So this man carried an attribute and like attributes of Christ, but he wasn't Christ. He was evil, and he was a Rakat Tamar, which means unclean spirit.
Which ye have not received, or another gospel, which ye have not accepted, ye might well bear with him.
And so that's pretty much what's going on. The vast majority of Christians accept this guy. They don't know the real Yahusha. So what I want to point out, Christ or Yahusha never told any of us to worship him, ever. But this man, this particular man that they now call Jesus, you will see that he wanted people to worship him. You know, he wanted people to pay homage to him. So read what you got, Acts 13 chapter from the top.
God, this is the book of Acts, chapter 13, verse 1. Now there were in
the... It's bested. Well, it's going to be wobbly again like that. All right, but you got it. Got it. So what?
Now there were in the church that was at Antioch.
So where's Antioch? Anyone know where Greece. Antioch is? Greece. On the map? What would that be called today? That's Upper Syria. That's Upper Syria. Antioch is Upper Syria. That's the first place where the Israelites was actually called Christians. And you'll find out they was called Christians because they was worshiping this false Messiah. They was worshiping this false Messiah, right? That carried the attribute of Ben Yahusha, meaning son of Christ. Got to read.
Was at Antioch certain prophets and teachers.
Okay, certain prophets. And then this man, he was a false prophet. So in order for someone to be a prophet, right? I mean, a false prophet, that means someone has to be looking to him as a prophet, right? For him to carry the attribute of a prophet. But he was a false prophet, and he had a lot of followers. And the people, the kings, and everyone, they accepted him. Mashiach. Got it.
As Barnabas and Simon that were called...
Now, this man, Simon, is the one that was a sorcerer. You're going to find out. He was a sorcerer, and people was worshiping him as the Messiah. Got it. Most Israelites, nobody catch this. Wait.
That was called Niger. And
so he was an Israelite. Mm-hmm. He was called Niger, which means modern day term, Inwell. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Niger. It means he was dark. You can look it up, man.
Mm-hmm. And Lucius of Cyrene and Mananim, which had been brought up with Herod the Tetrarch and Saul. verse 2. As they ministered to the Supreme Allah and fasted, the Ruach HaKadosh said, "Separate me from Barnabas and Saul, for the work whereunto I have called them."
And so when he said to separate me from Barnabas and Saul, so remember Saul's name is eventually changed to Paul. Mm-hmm. Paul was starting to take on this also, man. Okay, read.
And when they had fasted and prayed and laid their hands on them, they sent them away. Mm-hmm. Verse 4. So they being sent forth by the Ruach HaKadosh departed unto Seleucia, and from thence they sailed to Cyprus.
Watch this. Okay.
Verse 5. And when they were at Salamis, they preached the word of Yahweh in the synagogues of the Jews, and they had also Yochanan, John, to their minister. Verse 6. And when they had gone through the isle unto Paphos, they found a certain sorcerer.
Okay, now this man's a sorcerer. Now, a sorcerer is someone that practices what? Magic. Witchcraft. And he has people bewitched. So, remember they used to call Hamashiach, they say he was a sorcerer because he was able to work miracles. So, again, a sorcerer is also like a miracle worker. He appears to work miracles to people.
Appears.
Yeah, right? If you don't believe in miracles, they call it sorcery or they call it magic, right? So this guy was a true sorcerer. That means he was a witch. And he had a lot of the Israelites bewitched. Gotta read.
And when they had gone through the isle unto Paphos, they found a certain sorcerer, a false prophet.
Oh, see, he was a false prophet. So that means people had to be worshiping him as a prophet. He's a false prophet. Go ahead, read.
A false prophet, a Jew.
So he, a what?
A Jew.
So he was from the tribe of Judah. He was from the tribe of Judah. Read on. So that just like Hamashiach was from the tribe of Judah. Mm-hmm. This is a Christ that only Christians are worshiping today. They're worshiping this man, Simon. They carried the attribute of son of Yahusha, a son of Yahusha. Okay.
Whose name was Bar Yahusha.
So but that means son. They put a misnomer there. The word should have been Bon or Ben, meaning son. You go there. What does your Bible say in your sefer? It probably has son right there.
It says Bar Yahusha, but on the description of lexicon, it says of a Hebrew origin, son of Yahusha.
See that? See, I'm not making this up. So son of Yahusha. So he carried the attributes.
What is that prefix Bar? Son of?
Yeah, no, it means son. It's son. Just like okay. Bon. See, in Paleo Hebrew is B-A-N. Gone. And modern Hebrew is B-E-N. Yeah. Meaning son
okay,
of.
I seen the Ben. Yeah. Gone.
Okay. Yeah. But the Ben is just the modern Hebrew interpretation of right. Transliteration.
Were you saying it was Bar or what?
Bon.
Ben.
Bon. B-A-N.
Okay. Here's a Bar.
Yeah, that's a misnomer there. Also,
KB it says Bar dash Jesus.
Right. That means Yahusha.
Yeah.
Right. So that means son of Yahusha. That's the attribute that most Christians don't notice. They don't pay attention. They skip over the Bible, man. They don't know me,
know. I remember Simon. No, listen, I know Simon was
a yeah, literally.
But they worship him as the Messiah. That's who people worship in the day. Okay, you know.
Verse 7, which was the deputy of the country, mm-hmm. Sergius Paupus, a prudent man, who called for Barnabas and Saul, mm-hmm. and desired to hear the word of Yahweh. Mm-hmm. But Elamas...
Paul's going to say, yo, man, you are the devil, man. But where are you coming from with this? You a devil. Paul called him a demon. Okay,
but Elamas, the sorcerer, for so...
The sorcerer. See, now... What's his name? See, he's carrying many attributes.
Yeah.
You see that? Now they start calling him something else. What are they calling him right there?
Elamas.
Someone look up the word Elamas. See what that points back to. Points right back to this man out of the tribe of Judah. So he could fake it. He could say I'm the Christ because he came out of the tribe of Judah just like Yahusha did. Yahusha. But you got what you got?
First century AD, also known as Bar Jesus.
See? That's him. Son of Yahusha.
That's crazy.
See, that's it. Nobody catches it, man.
So they're telling you.
Because they're not moving in the right road. So go ahead, read. See how they switch the name up? Christian, I don't mean nothing. It's the same potion. Right. It's right there. They read it, they never knew it. They worship in this man, that's what they worshiped in the day. Mm-hmm. Now, every Christian is worshiping this man as Yahusha,
so
as a savior.
The disciples were sending, were spreading the word across Paul and them, they were spreading the word. And when they came up to Antioch, that's when they first started calling.
That's okay. When they started using that term, man. That's the only time that term Christ came out. There was first called, and the disciples was first called Jews, I mean Christians, in Antioch, in this place right here. Because they stood, they was worshiping this guy right here. They was worshiping him. So you got something?
Yeah, I got a precept here. Isaiah 19:3. And the Ruach of Mitzrayim shall fall in the midst thereof, and I will destroy the council thereof, and they shall seek to the idols, and to the charmers, and to them that have familiar spirits, and to the wizards.
See that? Mm-hmm. And they're all worshiping it. They were worshiping this man. The man was a sorcerer, but to them, it appeared that he was working miracles.
Familiar spirits.
Right, familiar spirits.
Wow.
Okay.
But Elamus the sorcerer, so is his name
Elamus, Ben Yahusha, the sorcerer, son of Yahusha. Okay.
So is his name by interpretation, mm-hmm. withstood them, seeking to turn away the deputy from the faith.
So he's trying to turn the sincere believers away from the faith. He wanted them to worship him, and they did. Okay.
Verse 9. Then Saul, who was also called Paul, filled with the Ruach HaKadosh, set his eyes on him. Verse 10, and said, O full of all subtlety and all mischief, thou child of the devil, thou enemy of all righteousness.
See, Paul was calling him everything. Child. Yeah, child of the devil. Thou child of the devil.
Not son.
The child of perdition.
Keep that.
Yeah, okay.
Wilt thou not cease to pervert the right ways of Yahweh? Mm-hmm. And now, behold, the hand of Yahweh is upon thee, and thou shalt be blind, not seeing the sun for a season. And immediately there fell on him a mist and a darkness, and he went about seeking some to lead him by the hand. Verse 12. Then the deputy, when he saw that when he saw what was done, believed, being astonished at the doctrine of the Supreme Allahan.
So everyone started to believe from the king on down. They started believing in this man, Simon, man. Simon, son of Yahusha.
Wait, how did his name keep changing? Is it through time?
We call him, it's just a different triple A. It says the transliteration. That was a transliteration of the name.
Like Yahweh Shai has many names.
Yeah.
Crazy because my grandma go to this church called Antioch.
So, I mean, there's nothing wrong with Antioch. That's just Upper Syria. Yeah, it just changed the name of it. Yeah. So we can see, let's go to Acts 8, verse 9, man. We can see this guy, man. They start worshiping. Acts 8, verse 9. What you got? Right, let him read it. You got the mic right there. You can get Matthew 1 and 21. We can see that the role Yahweh. He never tried to get us to worship him. I mean, this guy right here did. That's who people worship. The Christians that say Yahuwah and Yahusha is the same person, that's who they are worshiping. They're worshiping this guy. Because, think about it, Christ never told us to worship him. He always told us to worship the Father.
There's only one good.
Yeah. He always created this distinction. But this one right here, the Christians, they came up with that same paganistic Trinity doctrine. They came from Babylon. They tell you the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit is one and the same. That's going back to this guy, right? Yeah. Got Acts 8 and 9.
This is the book of Acts, chapter 8, verse 9. But there was a certain man called Simon, which before time in the same city used sorcery and bewitched the people.
So this is the same guy right here. This is the same guy. Simon. He bewitched the people. That means he had all the people deceived. He's using witchcraft for them. So he bewitched the people. Okay, read on.
And bewitched the people of Samaria, giving out that himself was some great one.
Mm-hmm. So they worship him as a great man. Okay, read on.
To whom they all gave heed,
So that means they all listened to him. They took heed to him. To give heed, meaning they, oh, wow, this is a magnificent man. Jim Jones effect, you know what I mean? Damn, where's the Kool-Aid? Go ahead, man. Go ahead.
From the...
If he's gonna hit him Kool-Aid, he's like, live forever. Everybody dead.
To whom they all gave heed, from the least to the greatest, saying.
So that means all the way up from the king, it says from the least, all the way down from, you know, whoever's sweeping the floors, all the way up to the king. From the least to the greatest. That's what that's saying. They all worship this man. Okay? Now remember, this man was out of the tribe of Judah. So he got posed like he was the Christ, right? So we read for 2 Corinthians 11:4, right? So he came out of the tribe of Judah. He fitted all the attributes. Because remember, Hamashiach was supposed to come out of the lineage of David. Right? What is that? Hebrews 11:4. Someone give me Hebrews 11:4. Christ was prophesied to come out of the seed line of David.
Come.
Yeah, hold what you got. So you get Hebrews 11:4. But we know that Yahushua comes out. Yeah, yeah, got it. Got
it. Book of Hebrews chapter 11, verse 4. By faith, Abel offered.
No, that's not it. It might be 7:14. 7 chapter 14 verse.
Come. Book of Hebrews chapter 7, verse 14. For it is evident that Supreme Elohim, well, no, that the Master sprang out of Judah,
Yahushua,
of which tribe Moses spake nothing concerning priesthood.
So that means Christ came out of the tribe of Judah. He came out of the royal seed line. Everybody knows Judah was a royal seed line, right? That's what all the kings came out of. King David, King Solomon, Christ. It was a royal seed line. And so that's why they got punished more. Remember, they went into captivity last. Because the 10 tribes strayed off first, right? So the Most High said, I'm going to punish you harder because you knew what not to do and you still did it. So you're going to stay in captivity longer. Go ahead.
Verse 15. And it is.
No, that was it. That's what we needed from that. Go ahead, Benign.
This is verse 10 again. Look at Acts chapter 8, verse 10. To whom they all gave heed, from the least to the greatest, saying, this man is the great power of Yahweh.
See? They thought he was Yahusha. You see what I'm saying? They said he's the great power of Yahusha. This man is the great power of Yahusha. They worship him. And that's who the Christians are still worshiping today. That's your Jesus you're worshiping.
Did they think Simon was the Messiah coming back?
Yeah, read that again tonight. Read that again. They say he's a great power of Yahusha.
Verse 9, is there was a certain man named Simon, and then we read in verse 10.
See, wherever he established in Acts, the first chapter, that the man was Simon on Yahusha, upon Yahusha, means Simon, the son of what they refer to now as Jesus. So we go back to Acts, the 8th chapter, it's telling us it's the same man, Simon. Someone look it up again. Can't tap dance with this. Someone look in the Bible dictionary, look up Simon ben Yahusha, or Simon ben Yahusha. That's the same guy. Okay, Benign?
I'm going to read verse 9 again. But there was a certain man called Simon, which before time in the same city used sorcery.
See, that's when we was talking about Acts the first chapter. As we read from the top. So he used sorcery. That means the man appeared to be a miracle worker. Got it.
And bewitched the people of Samaria.
Bewitched the people. That means he practiced witchcraft on them. He had them bewildered. When you bewitch someone, that means you have them deceived. So they're worshiping this man as he's the Most High.
Giving out that himself was some great one.
That he was great.
Verse 10. To whom they all gave heed.
They all listened to it.
From the least to the greatest, saying, this man is the great power of Yahweh.
See that?
Verse 11. And to him they had regarded, because that of long time he had bewitched them with sorcery.
So he had bewitched them with the power to work miracles. The sorcery, which is actually magic. So he was doing miraculous things. So they said, well, this man's got to be a savior. Okay.
Verse 12. But when they believed Philip, preaching the things concerning the kingdom of Yahweh, and the name of Yahweh Shah, of Hamashiach Yahweh Shah, They were baptized, both men and women.
Verse, now, so this guy, read.
Verse 13, then Simon himself believed also. Mm-hmm.
So they said he believed also, okay.
And when he was baptized, he continued with Philip, mm-hmm. and wondered, beholding the miracles and signs which were done. Verse 14, now when the apostles which were at Jerusalem heard that Samaria had received the word of Yahweh, they sent unto them Peter and John. Verse 15, who when they were come down, prayed for them that they might receive the Ruach HaKadosh. Verse 16, for as yet he was fallen upon none of them, only they were baptized in the name of HaMashiach Yahushua. They laid their hands on them, and they received the Ruach HaKadosh. And when Simon saw that through laying on of the apostles, hands of the Ruach HaKadosh was given, he offered them money, saying, give me also this power, that on whomsoever I lay hands, he may receive the Ruach HaKadosh. But Peter said unto him, thy money perish with thee, because thou hast thought that the gift of Yahweh may be purchased with money. Verse 21.
So preachers do the same, man. Until today, they say if you don't pay whatever, you're not going to make it. The prayers are not going to be answered.
Why did he get baptized?
Who's that? Go ahead. Stand the spirit. Okay.
Verse 21. Thou hast neither part nor lot in this matter, for thy heart is not right in the sight of Yahweh.
See that? Let me ask you this, man. Have you ever been baptized?
Yeah.
Have you sinned after that?
Yeah.
Someone give me Ephesians 5:23. What a baptism doesn't work, man.
Okay.
You got to be clenched with the washing of the water of the word. How many women that you know that went in, got water, got immersed in water,
what
does it? And they still go out and they commit adultery the next day, the next weekend. Water baptism didn't work. So HaMashiach, how many people did he baptize? None. Mm-hmm. He baptized them with the water. So they needed a spiritual cleansing. Water baptism doesn't work. That ended with John and the apostles, they baptizing people. But Christ said, I'm going to baptize with the washing of the water, the word. Okay, Ephesians 5:26.
Oh,
who got that?
Yeah, I got it. Okay.
Yeah,
good. This is the book of Ephesians, chapter 5, verse 26. In order to set it apart and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, in order to present it to himself a splendid assembly, not having spot or wrinkle or any of this sort.
So with Christ, water baptism is not necessary, needed anymore. Only Baptists still believe in that, and those were followers of John, y'all can know it. But with Christ that will end it, you have to be cleansed with the washing of the water of the word. Because people get baptized and they still go out in their sin, because your spirit has to be clean. So the word is what? Keeping the law. Okay.
What I learned about the baptism that John, why he baptized Christ, was because that's how the priest would pass on the high priest to Christ. And when the Most High, or when Christ filled the seat of Melchizedek, that order, there was no more after him.
Right. So we don't need water baptism anymore. You don't have to be baptized. You got to be baptized with this water, man. Then the spirit. So that's what the ruach is. The word ruach hakadosh means the set apart spirit. That's a Hebrew word that means set apart spirit. They call it holy. Anything holy, it means it's set apart. It's different from everything else. So it's a different spirit. Right? Okay. Go ahead, Benign.
Verse 21, this book of Acts, chapter 8, verse 21. Thou hast neither part nor lot in this matter, for thy heart is not right in the sight of Yahweh.
See that?
Repent therefore of this thy wickedness, and pray Yah, if perhaps the thought of thine heart may be forgiven thee. Verse 23. For I perceive that thou art in the gall of bitterness, and in the bond of iniquity. Verse 24. Then answered Simon and said, pray ye to the supreme Allahan for me, that none of these things which ye have spoken come upon me. And they, which they had testified and preached the word of Yahweh, returned to Jerusalem and preached the gospel in many villages of the Samaritans. Verse 26. And the angel of the Supreme Allahan spake unto Philip, saying, Arise, and go toward the south, unto the way that goeth down from Jerusalem, unto Gaza, which is desert.
Now, this Simon right here is not talking about Simon Peter, whose surname is Peter. This is talking about Simon, whose surname was son of Yahusha, Yahusha. So don't mistake this with Simon Peter.
This isn't the rock.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah, this is not Simon Peter the Rock. I mean, it said it, you got to think. Because it said Simon, whose surname was Peter, right? But this is Simon, son of Yahusha, right? You see how when we read the Surah, it's called the Wisdom of Yahusha?
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
So there was many people carrying the attribute Yahusha, Yahusha in the Bible.
Right.
Right? So, but you could drop that. Let's go to Matthew 1 and 25. So you can see that Hamashiach never told us to worship him. Hamashiach done everything that a man did, and he didn't acknowledge himself as the Most High. Never. He never acknowledged himself as the Most High.
I'm going to put something real quick on that.
Yeah, go ahead.
Just talking from coming out of Babylon, out of Christianity, realizing the prophetic name of Yahushua, Yahweh, made the big difference of having the faith in Christ versus having the faith of Christ.
Right.
Yahweh's name is I am He who breathes life. I am the source of life. Christ's name is Yah is salvation. You know, he's pointing back to the Father again, right, being the Savior, you know. So for me, that was so edifying, you know, to realize that you need to have that relationship with the Most High through Christ, you know, understanding that.
So Matthew 1 and 25?
Yeah, 1 and 25, got it.
It's the book of Matthew, chapter 1, verse 25. And knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son. And he called his name Yahusha.
All right, go ahead, keep reading.
Chapter 2.
So we can see he was actually the son of someone. The Most High is not the son of anyone, right? He's not the son of anyone. So Yahusha was. Go ahead, Ken.
Yeah, I got another precept to enforce what you're saying. This is the book of Romans, chapter 2, verse 28.
Mm-hmm.
For he is not a Yehudi, a Jew, who is so outwardly, neither is circumcision that which is outward in the flesh, but a Yehudi is he who is so inwardly, and circumcision is that of the heart, in ruach, not literally, whose praise is not from men, but from Yahuwah.
Let's get Matthew 3 and 13. Someone get Matthew 3 and 13. Someone get Matthew 8 and 24. We'll see that Yahusha done all of the things that a man did. He never told us to worship him. But Christians worship him every day.
It's the book of Matthew, chapter 3, verse 13. Then cometh Yahusha from Galilee to Jordan unto John, to be baptized of him.
Okay, so he was baptized. The Most High doesn't need to be baptized. God the Father, if you want to call him that, wake him up, man. He should be taking his vibration with him. Him and Biggie. Should be taking it. You're going to be sleeping in hell too, man. Or screaming. Forever, man. God.
Okay.
So he was baptized. So the Most High has no need to be baptized. Because he's the omnipotent. He's in charge of war. Let's get Matthew 8 and 24. And someone get Matthew 11 and 19.
Matthew chapter 8, verse 24. And behold, there arose a great tempest in the sea.
Great storm in the sea. Got it.
Insomuch that the ship was covered with the waves, but he was asleep. And his disciples came to him and awoke, saying, Master, save us, we perish. And he said unto them.
So, the only thing I wanted out of that is that Yahusha sleeps. The Most High never sleeps. That's all I wanted out of that. Yahusha sleeps. Showing you the distinctions between him and the Most High. The Most High doesn't have that attribute that he sleeps. He's always awake. That's the attribute of a man that sleeps. Go ahead. Who got the next precept?
I got it.
Someone got Matthew 4 and 1 through 2. Read what you got, King.
I got 11 and 13.
Huh? All right, yeah, got it.
There's the book of Matthew, chapter 11.
Someone get Mark 1 and 9.
Okay. Chapter 11, verse 13. For all the prophets and the Torah prophesied to Yahweh. And if you wish to accept it, he is Eliyahu, who was about to come.
Come. So he came. That's Christ. Christ came. Came to earth as a man.
What does Eliyahu mean?
What was that?
It says Eliyahu. What does that mean?
I am the separate.
The short for Yahuwah, the guy.
Yeah, it just says Elohim of Yahweh.
Yeah.
Oh,
right. Yeah, it's just short for Yahuwah, meaning the Most High.
Book of Matthew, chapter 4, verse 1. Then was Hamashiach led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil.
Okay, you can't tempt the Most High. Right. So Christ had an attribute, he could actually even be tempted, like a man. You can't tempt the Most High. Okay.
Verse 2. And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward and hungered.
Does the Most High need to eat?
No,
he doesn't need to eat. Adam and Eve would have never have to eat, man. Until Eve committed that sin, man. They would have never had to eat to live. Now if you don't eat, you would die. That didn't come into the world until sin came into the world. They could have eaten, but they didn't have to eat to live. But the curse came on Adam that now you're going to have to work for your food for the rest of your life. You're going to die. Yeah. Someone got Mark 1 and 9? We got that already? Mark 1 and 13.
Mark 1 and 13.
And someone get Luke 2 and 21.
I got it.
Mark 1 and 13. And he was there in the wilderness 40 days, tempted.
Okay, now he's tempted. So Christ can be tempted. Yahushua can be tempted. Read it again. I'm not making it up.
He was there in the wilderness 40 days, tempted of Satan.
Can Satan tempt the Most High? No. He had to come to the Most High just to get approval to tempt Job. In the book of Job, right? But apparently Yahushua can be tempted, right? He carried the attributes of a man. He came through the womb of a woman, man. And his father was Joseph, not no immaculate conception, man. What would happen if, you came home and your daughter said, oh, the Holy Ghost got me pregnant? You gonna go for that?
Hell no.
A ghost going around getting girls pregnant. Come on, man. That's made up. That's a fabricated story. But you know what they tell you? They bewitch you. Like this man, he bewitch you, say, oh, this is God. He can do anything. And
right.
You say, okay. It don't sound like it. Right. How come we can't do it anymore?
Right, right.
What was that?
I'm trying to remember it right now. It's in the Apocrypha, Wisdom of Solomon. Speak on the fashion in the womb, 10 months.
Oh, yeah. But that was just saying. Yeah. Yeah, I know what you're talking about, too. Did someone get
the book of Luke, chapter 2, verse 21. And when 8 days were accomplished for the circumcision.
So Christ had to get circumcised. Now, if that's his law, why you got to follow his own law? Most High don't have to get circumcised. He gave that law to Moses to identify who an Israelite was. Okay, read.
And when 8 days were accomplished for the circumcising of the child, his name was called Hamashiach, which was so named of the angel before he was conceived in the womb.
So he carried all these attributes of a man, not of the Most High, man. But people worship him. People worship him still to this day. That's all the precepts. Yachin 4 and 26. Luke 8 and 23. Did we get the Luke 2 and 21?
Come on. Go on. Book of Luke, chapter 8, verse 23. But as they sailed, he fell asleep.
So, Hamashiach slept. Most High doesn't sleep, right? Who's on the job if he's asleep? Sorry, Anthony, I missed your prayer. I was sleeping. See how that sound? Come on, man. Being serious. It's trivial, but it's serious, man. How can he be the omnipotent if he's sleeping? I gotta take a nap, man. Get a lot of sleep last night. Had to go to that ceremony. It's serious. See what I'm saying? But Yahusha slept. He carried on the attributes of a man. All these attributes of men, manly attributes, man. But people worship him. He never told you to worship him, man. Nowhere in the scriptures did he tell you to worship him. He said you could get to the Father by me. There's no way to get in heaven besides going through the Son. That's what he told you to do. He didn't say worship me. You can't find one place in the scripture where he said to worship me. No way. That's Christianity, man. That's a religion. Most I don't deal with religion. Someone look at the etymology of the word religion. The word religion means to bind, to restrain, to return to bondage. That's what religion means. All religions hold you down and restrain you and return you to bondage.
Yeah, obligation. It says obligation, bond, reverence.
Yeah, so look at the etymology of the word. Let's get to the etymology.
Yeah, it's right here.
It should be more words.
It says Latin religare, to bind.
Right, religare.
Religio,
right.
Obligation, bond, reverence.
So that's what religion is.
So a reverend is binding the people in the church.
Right.
Oh, wow. That's casting spells, man.
John 20 and 17.
Same thing to John. 24.
Bring it over.
The book of Yachanan, John, chapter 4, verse 24. Yahweh is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and truth. 25. The woman saith unto him, I know that Messiah cometh, which is called Hamashiach. When he is come, he will tell us all things. Hamashiach saith unto her, I that speak unto thee am he.
You want that John
20:17?
Someone get Matthew 28:18. Look at Yachanan, John. Chapter 20, verse 17. Yahushua said unto her, touch me not, for I have not yet ascended to my Father. Okay, so there's a distinction right now. If he's the Most High, what is he descending? He's ascending to himself. So that's a direct distinction between Yahuwah and Yahusha. I have not yet ascended to my Father. He's making a direct distinction. But you guys want to believe in a Trinity. The whole Trinity doctrine came out of Babylon. The whole doctrine of Krishna that has that's a man with a woman body came out of Babylon.
Yeah.
Shiva, all of that came out of Babylon. Yeah. It comes from the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, or the Holy Spirit. The Father being Nimrod. And so when Nimrod died, that's where the whole Christmas doctrine come from. Yeah. When Nimrod died, an evergreen tree supposedly sprung up overnight.
Okay.
Then his mom, that he actually had sex with, who became his wife, Semiramis. No, it's true, man.
Yeah, no.
You know, told everyone, if you don't worship him and place a gift under the tree, Nimrod was born on December 25th. If you don't leave a gift under the tree, the curse of Nimrod is going to come upon you. So they start leaving gifts under the tree. And so when the sun reflected on her womb, she told him, now Nimrod is the sun god. That's how people started worshiping Ra. And so she said when the sun reflected down on her womb and impregnated her. And impregnated her with Tammuz, right?
Tammuz, yeah.
Yeah, Tammuz, which is actually the sun. So now the sun went into her womb and came back as Tammuz. So now you have the Father, the Son, and you got the Queen of Heaven.
Hold on.
So the Queen of Heaven in the Bible is talking about Semiramis. That's why people put candles on birthday cakes. Mm. Birthday cakes originally was made in the form and the shape of moons and circles, and so they would put candles on them to represent the depths of hell. So they was paying homage to Semiramis, who's the Queen of Heaven in the Bible. So every woman is referring to themselves as queen because there was never a queen in Israel. Israelites didn't have queens. The other nations did. You said that was Queen Esther. But she had to lie about her nation. Mm. When she was a queen, she wasn't a queen in Israel. Israel only had kings. You don't hear about any Israelite queen or anything like that, man. That's not of our nation, man. We didn't even have a king. They begged for a king. The Most High saw a crisis king. Yahusha's king. And when they got one, what happened? Saul, he became mad wicked.
Oh, that's why I forgot what book, but it's like they start weeping over Tammuz and what they're referencing is.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's his son.
Yeah.
So that's what the Trinity comes from. That's what the papacy, the Pope, and then picked it up from Babylon. It all came out of Babylon. Okay. Remember, Nimrod's the same one that's trying to build the Tower of Babel. The word Babel means confusion, right? So the people got confused. So when they try to build the tower in the Shemayim, the Most High confused their languages. Initially, everyone on earth spoke the same language, it says. And so he caused a confusion at the Tower of Babel.
They all took the story back. They all had the same story. So when they split, right. They all had the same story in different languages.
I was going to say, Tammuz also meant perfected by fire, too. We go back to that sun worship and all
right.
Yeah.
So you get the symbolism a lot in the Catholic and Roman churches of them having that sun above their images and the paintings.
The obelisk represents the penis of Nimrod. The sundial represents the woman's vagina. Yeah. And so, because all of it goes back to fertility. You found out that most of these gods was gods of fertility. That was what it's all about. They're making sacrifices of the babies. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yo, you got that?
Give me the mic. Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 7. I myself also am a mortal man, like to all, and the offspring of him that was first made of the earth. And in my mother's womb was fashioned to be flesh.
What precept is that?
It's the one for...
Wisdom of Solomon? So they can know.
Okay, it's the Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 7, verse 1. I myself also am a mortal man, like to all, and the offspring of him that was first made of the earth. Verse 2. And in my mother's womb was fashioned to be flesh in the time of 10 months, being compacted in blood of the seed of man and the pleasure that came with sleep. And when I was born, I drew in the common air and fell upon the earth, which is of like nature. And the first voice which I uttered was crying, as all others do. I was nursed in swaddling clothes, and that with cares. Verse 5, for there is no king that had any other beginning of birth. Verse 6, for all men have one entrance into life and the light going out. Verse 7, wherefore I prayed and understanding was given me. I called upon Elohim and the spirit of wisdom came to me.
I got that chapter 28 and 18. And Yahusha came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given up unto me in Shemayim and in Eretz. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Ruach HaKadosh, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even until the end of the world. Amen.
All right. Let's take a 10-minute break, because everybody's just walking in the back and getting snacks and all of that, man. So let's take a 10-minute break. We're going to get started in 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Like 10 minutes sharp. Hey, what was it?